Japan. Obviously, these two teams know each other so well. Regular contest in Asia Cup. They've only ever had two games in World Cup history, both being won by China. But here's the schedule for the quarterfinal qualifications. The first two games are here in Santa Cruz in Tenerife. And then we will go to the venue in Cristopal with France and Turkey, Spain and Senegal. Nigeria, Greece follow this. Kick it off with China and Japan looking for a place in the quarterfinal and a tie against Australia. Just about to get into individual player introductions. Give me a chance to introduce Teresa Brandlova, who's the former Czech international, has been in the latter stages of World Championships. This is when it really starts, right? This is winner stays, loser goes home.
This is exactly the moment every team who has made the stage of the tournament was waiting for, and it will be interesting to see if it's going to get into the heads of the players that it's such an important moment in this tournament, because whoever loses goes home.
Well, as a result of the qualification, the group phase round, Japan finishing third in their group, China finishing second behind the United States in theirs. Japan being introduced, and they're a breath of fresh air. They're up tempo, they shoot the ball, they defensively, I think, they probably put the best organized defense on the floor, Teresa, and they're just such fun to watch.
Yeah, I can agree with that, because we see that Japan just steps on the court with such energy, such joy of the game. And as you already said, they work very compact as a defensive team at this tournament, which is something they have to do because they don't have a size within their rosters, for example, China has. So they really need to focus on the team defense. And so far, this tournament, they've been very successful. They also play really physical game in terms of conditioning. They really keep moving the ball well offensively. They keep moving players, filling the positions. So it's really fun to watch them.
Oh, head coach Tom Bassi. Got to say, he epitomizes and really respects Japanese culture's understatement. Really fits this group. It's such a good feel. Here come China. And again, a team that's changed its culture, a team that's changed its feel. Plays with a huge smile on the face, enjoys the experience. Game time is fun time for them. And they have got the nine players, 23 and under, 24 and under. Couple of vets out there to give them a little bit of experience. But this team, again, been a bit of a revelation, building on their performances in Asia Cup last year. And now, as they showed in the 12-point loss to United States, knocking on the door at the top of the tree. Now we'll have the national anthems as coach Zhu Limin gets introduced. Now we have the national anthems of both teams, starting with Japan.
First, the anthem of Japan.
National anthem of China. Coaches and players exchanging mementos at the halfway line. Have a look at the rosters after we've had a look at the 13. Going to introduce the officials on this game this morning. Early start, to be fair, 11:30. And here are the third members of the 13 in tonight's game. Russell, crew chief, with Marcus Fosberg and Georgios Corsandis from France, Denmark and Greece, respectively. If you're refereeing in the knockout stages, you've done a good job in this tournament. Refereeing has been of the highest level, as you'd expect, obviously, at a World Cup. Taking a look at the rosters here is this Japanese roster. For me, Takahata is one of those players that coaches die for because she just puts it out there every day. Most minutes played in the tournament and just keeps coming back for more, Teresa.
I can only agree, and she has been also 100% from the three-throw line. It just supports me saying that Japan is really, really successful, shooting 87%. Look at this lineup, Mizushima, Takada, Motohashiki, Mabuli, Miyazawa. Miyazawa has been very impressive at this tournament as well, scoring 12 points first game, 21 first points, 15. So, and she also delivers the ball. And here we have that leader of the Japanese team, Takada, as you already mentioned. She has been just great at this tournament, and we've seen game that she's able to attack from any position. She's not simply just the center, but she can really attack from the top of the key. She can shoot the ball. So really, really impressive performance at this tournament.
China, this roster, as we said, so young. Only has the three players over 24. This roster is going to be here for a long, long time. Xiaoting's been tremendous, and they just have the young twin towers, Teresa. What potential talent these kids have.
Yeah, and all the guards and basically all the players from Japan, from China, they said they work as a compact team as well. The first game at this tournament, when they played Latvia, they were a little bit looking for themselves from free throw lines and on the rebound, but Ding Xiao, she just delivers the ball really well. She organizes offense, and she's a true leader to this China team. You already mentioned that China is in transition. They have such a quality under the rim. Yang Zhu has proven that she probably is going to get drafted very soon to WNBA.
Zhu Raimin, the coach, has to take a lot of credit with change of culture, if that's not too strong a word. This team plays up tempo, it plays with a smile. Tom Ovasi, again, as we mentioned right at the beginning of the cast of the game here, is that he has added some dimensions to the play from a technical level, but he fits into the way that the Japanese team want to play. They want to exist. So both coaches have, in their own ways, have molded and changed the culture of these teams, and it's had a massive impact on their actual performance on the floor.
Yeah, back to Chinese team. They have 11 blocks at this tournament so far, and Japan really needs to carry on with that great ball movement offensively to avoid China back their players down under the rim to be able to block another shot at this tournament.
Well, the Spanish Federation again, because it's a morning game, has again brought in some local school children who are going to again remember this day for a while, because they're seeing two great teams. They're making a lot of noise. Players are going to really respond to that, as well as those kids remembering it as a highlight of their young school life. Well, Japan have really built this march through this tournament on their defense and their tempo. They have really got to keep China out of the keyway. They've really got to keep them off the glass, as most games in, at this stage always come down to. You win the glass, you've got a pretty good chance of winning the game. So welcome to Santa Cruz in Tenerife Bay. China in the white, Japan in the red. Mr. Russo doing just a little bit of maintenance and tidying up around the circle. And we're underway, the first quarterfinal playoff game. Winner gets to the quarterfinal with the prize of facing Australia. And China go deep first time, inside out. Again, that defense from Japan, straight at them, and the three is good though. Just strokes from somewhere around, just tremendous execution and composure. It won't faze the Japanese though. They missed the two. I mean, we'll move it high. They look high-low. Help comes. The double team forces through that double team. The own rebound is good. Gets another shot at it. And we got a hell ball. And yeah. Li Yuru has just got to finish those plays.
She got to finish. And you also have to ask the question when she has two defenders on her. Her teammate, the Yao Ting, was right next to her, so just drop the ball down and avoid the double, what the Chinese obviously are trying to play defensively.
Into the half court. Takada out top for Japan. Louis is guarded, they take her off the passing. Great first step and contact. All about the first step, all about the rip through. And Motohashi just exploded to the hoop.
That was a great recognition that she has been isolated on the whole half, basically alone, and she was quick enough to attack Liu Yan.
Motohashi.
And to be honest, Japanese needs to play really quick. They really need to run the floor up and down and try to kind of be quicker than the tallest Chinese team in this game.
Riley, kind of the Hikis club in the Japanese league, and this whole program working towards World Cup success and then Olympic success. That's the ambition, that's the plan. Xiao Ting, nowhere to go. Spin to the inside is not done again. The Japanese defense, just outstanding. A tough one from Malumi, just blocks it. Everyone in stance, they push it. Motohashi gets to the foul line, inside out. Malumi with the three, gets! Started it with a block, rewarded with the pass, knocks the three down. You gotta love it.
You gotta love the tempo the game has started with. It's just incredible from both sides.
Foul line jump shot off the glass. Banks have been open for a couple of hours in Tenerife. Jai Singh, confidence on the free throw. Malumi goes deep. Ball's knocked away. Is it Yawa? Couldn't handle it. China in transition. Li Yuan decides there isn't an option. Low post option. They come back to the same side. Malumi takes the ball fake. Great work. How did Motohashi get back in the play? Just would not stop. Relentless. Tremendous start to the game. Motohashi stumbles, needs a pass, has to pass, in fact. And pressure's taken off as Yawa. Motohashi for three. It's just downtown and knocked down. Motohashi, five personal.
It tells you straight away, it's going to be such an exciting game to watch. And you almost feel sorry that these two teams has met each other in the qualification for quarterfinals.
Yuru misses the close one, but Xiao Ting does what she's done all tournament, picks up the rubbish, and great lead pass. Nagioko couldn't finish, but Japan just looking to run. Motohashi doesn't get, Maluda gets and looks underneath, puts it on the floor. Inside out, so Motohashi back-to-back threes, is it? Yes, it is.
And this tells you about the quality of Japan. Motohashi just hit three, so the team effort plays for her again to get her to the position when she's on fire.
Jassin moves it on. Li Meng goes back, little two-man game, spins to the middle, blocked. Tremendous.
Look at Nagioka.
Motohashi down the lane and blows the layup. Obviously far too close. Xiao Ting in transition. Goes through the contact. Wants the jump, gets the jump.
Straight two players recover defensively all the way, and Xiao Ting now is asking her teammates, come and support me. Look at that, straight away two Japanese on Xiao Ting.
Sun Mengram will check in for China as we get a replay of the second of the threes.
This is a great look from Mabule.
China trying to spend some time with the ball. Really do need to go with the inside. Nice cut from Xiao Ting. Gets the little push from 4 feet. Great recognition because the help, the guy guarding her, was more intent on looking to help on the block. Louis puts it on the floor. Inside out, extra pass to the corner. Had to share a ball. The three is off. Yuru comes down with the defensive rebound. And Xiao Ting says, okay, let's have a look at what we have. Sun Mengram in the block, feels the double team. They go inside and out. Gets the little short jumper to drop.
That was a great reposition action. When the big kicks the ball out and adjust the position to more effective way.
We're locked to 11. Wow. Motohashi gets the double digits.
And again, this isolation of Japanese player Motohashi on the half court.
There's a reluctance to give Yuru the basketball at the minute.
And this is such a danger too of Japanese because they have scored more three-pointers than any other team during this World Cup so far.
And Sun is no good with the mid-range jumper. Motohashi with a motor. This is a great engine. Comes, turns the corner, gets to the keyway, inside out, extra pass. They've moved the ball again, attack the closeout. Wide open, Malui for three, it's good. I trust my teammate, I trust my team. This team shares the ball as well as anybody in world basketball. Malui with all day because the ball movement was just exceptional. 16 to 11, stolen. Japan do not give you a moment. Malui with the layup on the end of the break. China take the timeout. Both teams are ready to play, but at the moment, Japan are at a different level. They lead it 18 to 11, 3:52 to go in the first.
That's such impressive stars to this game from Japan. But Mark, we knew that Japan plays this way. They will run the floor. They are so effective from outside, same as inside. It's a very, very tough task for a Chinese team in today's game. Look at that percentage of the shooting. 67 for Japan. Six assists tells you how well they share the ball. It's not just one player. It's not just Motohashi. It's Mabule. It's Takada. Such dangerous team.
No need for China to panic at all here. Japan have been very efficient from those turnovers. There's eternity left in the game, and Japan may well be, as we've said, the leading three-point percentage team in the competition, but are they going to be able to continue at this level? China need to make the adjustments. One of the adjustments they're going to make straight away is that Hanzhou's going to check in. There will not be the same reluctance, I don't think, to go inside, because Hanzhou has just... it's a revelation, yeah, but she's a target they want to give the ball to. Here they go, out the timeout. They'll want to see an adjustment what they need to do is stop that, slow down that ball movement.
That'll be such important for Japan to play and to be without the ball.
Su with a little rush on the jumper. She doesn't need to be because she's not going to get that blocked. Murahashi slips and falls and turns it over. Maybe even too quick for herself, remarkably. Wang's go by Ohio. Low, the defense just swarms and drops. The three has gone and off. Defensive rebound, Murahashi has it again. Takada needs a pass. Murahashi. Takada thinks about the long two, puts it on the floor, stolen. And for the first time, they bounced the basketball before the ball movement, and it led to the turnover. And Xiaoting doesn't need a second invitation to get into a passing lane. Nice little group of traveling Chinese fans who've just loved the experience here in Tenerife so far. Ziyawa on the dribble, gets into the keyway, stops and pops for two. Nagioka turned the corner. A 20 to 13 start, just over two to go. Well, she can shoot the ball, she has shown, takes a big step, is fouled. You've got to love the way this 18-year-old plays the game. 2 meters five, puts the ball on the floor with no fear.
Look at that aggression into that penetration. It's just beautiful to play. And 18 years is, wow. This kid has a future.
Takada outside the three, moves it on to get the quick release on the three and just knock it down.
We've seen this from Yuki Miyazawa. She's just effective. She reads her defender so well. If you're going to go under or you oversleep in the defense, I'm going to shoot the ball.
Xiaoting thinks about putting it on the floor. Gets it back, looks underneath, post entry. The defense doubles down, extra pass out of it. They can't then make the extra pass. The three is away and knocked down. 0.9 on the possession. Yang Liwei. Rui on the inside with a little reverse layup.
Beautiful.
And Japan almost get out of that one with just by outworking China. Second trailer again. Xiaoting in the lane, wide open. Mid-range two is short. Xiaoting gets it knocked away, comes off her leg, and the ball will belong to Japan.
Great hustle with Takada. She didn't give up that rebound. Right after this shot, you will see her quick hands pass the deflection.
Five-point game, as well as Japan have played. They only lead by five because China aren't that far behind in terms of the execution.
We see China now adjusted the defense. They're chasing players into the screens, trying to allow them to get the easy shots. Whoa.
Kala gets deep with the mismatch. The help is late and she gets the two.
And that's exactly what the good ball movement and good movement on the offensive half does. There's going to be mismatches and advantage.
Great seal. Fouled on the way up, and she did get the presence of mind to put the shot up just in case the referee was going to debate whether or not it was shooting. Really did a great job on the seal. As we get another look at Takada underneath, the release is quick, the help can't come, seals off, gets the mismatch, recognition, and the two.
And the timing of the pass is as well really on point, because we could see that Zhang Su was coming to recover, but just the timing of the pass was excellent, on point. And Mavule has picked her second personal foul in this game.
That's called a hometown roll for Hanzu. 32 seconds left in the first quarter, 25-19. It's been a relentless pace. Doesn't get the roll on the second one. China had some issues from the free throw line opening day. It put those behind them in the next two games. Almost cost them the win. There's around a 7 second differential. Fujioka tries to scoop it, comes off her head, and China will have 9.2 seconds close the quarter with the points.
There has been a bit not enough movement, let's say, offensively, because Fujioka just was holding the ball quite long.
Wang Xia puts it on the floor, in the lane, kicks it. They're going to have to put this up. They take the three, it's short. And that will be another defensive rebound stat for Takada. And we've reached the end of one. And that was at a relentless pace. Japan have the 25-19 lead at the end of the first quarter. Wow, just catch your breath for 2 minutes. I think you're going to need it. That was absolutely relentless. What a great first quarter to this playoff game. Here are the statistics for that game. I'll make a statement. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be okay with this one. Japan are not going to shoot 83% from the three-point line across this game, and they've shot 83%, and they lead only by six, so it gives you the quality of the game, let alone their own quality from the perimeter. But if you want these stats and every stat as we get into the knockout stages of this Women's World Cup, download the app from your normal source, get all the information. Get involved, get as much information as you can. If you're in the islands, in the Canary Islands, and able to get here, there's still tickets for some of these playoff games. Check it out, get down to see the best in the world. But if you can't, download that app. Get involved on all the social media. We just love to see what people are thinking of this competition, because so far it's been absolutely phenomenal at times. We've had some great games already, and now we're in the knockout stages. Japan will have possession of the basketball at the start of two. Jeez, I don't think China should be too perturbed here. I mean, I don't think Japan could play any better than that. And they still only trail six.
Yeah, and we know both teams are very consistent in their performance when it comes to the game, how it goes up and down. They're very stable emotionally, so no need to panic. Both teams playing pretty much really, really well.
Japan will weave it in the half court, looking to turn the corner. The mid-range is fouled, and that's just not the smartest move by Wang Siyu. Just walked underneath the shooter when the shooter was already off balance.
To be honest, I haven't seen this wave so long in basketball, because that's usually when you play this offense usually at the youth level, but Japan is so quick and they really all working effectively to create those mismatches, which obviously Fujioka right now has used for that quick pull-up jump shot after the screen.
Count it. A lane violation on the defensive side.
And that's what's expected straight away. Japanese go and play his own pressing.
Great rebound. You're 2-on-1. You take the short one. You know you've got one of the best rebounders in the tournament down the floor with your hand goes to 5. That's going to be held. And for the first time, I think, in the whole tournament, Takada just couldn't hold a space enough to get the patted ball in the lane.
Yeah, Sun Mingran really has done a great job to be in the passing lane.
Yang Liwei gets it into the half court. Then Graham will look to Flair, puts it on the floor, kicks to the wing. The long two is short. Great effort on the glass. That is a battle. Well, Fujioka sits, and the player of the first quarter, Nako Motohashi, checks in. Motohashi looks the handoff.
It's only 5 seconds on the shot clock. Not sure if Japanese knows about it.
Whoa. Penetration by Motohashi.
Right on time.
I don't think there's anything that Motohashi doesn't know about at the moment. She is so much in the zone of this game. Wide open for the three is an answer. Yang Liwei gets the three. China close it to five. Motohashi gets it back. She's literally orchestrating every facet of what Japan is doing. Takada, mid-range two is short. Got a foul on the rebound. And again, physical commitment to the work on the glass is going to be rewarded. Endline possession.
Mangtzu couldn't do any more because she was on the mismatch. She was the one disadvantage in the size under the rim. And that's her second personal foul in this game.
Yuan checking in. Well, the three is gone. Short. And Zhu gets one of the easier rebounds he's going to get. Early post entry. Zhu will just flash but doesn't get. Sam Rengan goes to the middle. Little short jumper is no good. Zhu's on the glass. Inside position. She just worked the baseline so well, but the ball pretty much at the underside of the ring and just came down too quickly for her. I know it feels like that sometimes. Such a frustration. You love the emotion with this crowd. 7:50 to go in the second quarter. 5-point game. Motohashi at speed just rounds the baseline, then looks inside. They try and isolate on the wing, spin to the baseline for the two is no good. Big time challenge on the shot, a lot of ring protection. Li Yuan, second trial, looks at the options, and the options isn't to throw it to the press who sit up the baseline there.
And we see Chinese Liu Yang now full good playing man to man, Motohashi. Trying to slow her down a little bit. It's our job. Motohashi is really, really
into the half court.
On fire today.
With the Yawa baseline needs a pass, finds one. The short jumper is floated and short. And China are establishing a little bit of control at the defensive end. They're forcing the tough shot. And Japan haven't been able to be released wide open on the help on the weak side. They didn't look. The three is taken because there's no other option, but so what? If you're not going to move, I'm going to shoot it. And Xi Jing has range, has genuine range. 2-point game, Motohashi at speed for two, gets the drop. Motohashi is having a night. Unbelievable numbers at the moment. China answer again. And this is probably Li Yuru's most complete performance at the moment.
She was struggling with personal fouls in this tournament so far.
Motohashi drops it short, but Takada can't bail her out, can't get the offensive rebound. And Japan want to talk it over. 6:09 to go in the half, as we get Motohashi doing what Motohashi has done phenomenally well in this tournament.
believe it or not, Motohashi is on 14 points already in this game, shooting 56%, 67 from three-point line. She's such effective because she can be such danger from a perimeter and also into that penetration. China really needs to play a team defense on her.
Well, Maludi's going to come back in after the timeout. We're going to look at the percentages. Japan's starting to cool down a little bit, down at 50 now.
And now we can see that that percentage of three-point shots of Japan from the first quarter has dropped to 56% from 83%.
China getting contributions off the bench, but you'd expect that because obviously Han Zhu doesn't start. So China with the basketball down two, have a chance to tie it or even take the lead. They led the first possession, since then it's been Japan, and at times Japan by double digits. For the three for the lead is long. Defensive rebound is pulled in by Mizuyawa. Again, they get into this movement. China doing a great job at slowing it out. They throw it down, should be. Xiao Ting gets composed and collects herself, gets the two. And we have a new ball game with 5:30 to go. Wide open for three, is good. Nagaoka goes to five and didn't doubt herself for a second, just stroked it. The second trowel down the floor has been a real feature on a lot of teams. Push the ball early, get the defense flattened out, and your second trailer, if they can stretch the floor, is a real threat. Foul line jump shot is good. Xi Jing drops it. Super game. Takahaka, Takada, outside, will move it on. And Takada's taken a little of a supportive role. She's read the situation here. Takahashi, what a drive to the far side of the ring. Mashida protects it, gets the two, gets the foul, goes to the free throw line.
And the quickness of the guards of Japan's causing a bit issues to Chinese defense. There's no one really to stop these penetrations. And that's because Japanese move so well offensively on the court. They never stop for a second. So Chinese defense is engaged every time.
Well, can't complete the M1. Early pass, Xiao Ting gets the two.
And this is given points from Japan because they have been defensively in a position. They just didn't pay attention, didn't expect this pass for Xiao Ting.
Well, China looked to run at every opportunity, as do Japan. Well, Takada with easy two. Someone on the help side was somewhere else, with someone else. Lots of someones and somewheres. What it meant was no help. Someone else's responsibility, unfortunately. Xiao Ting. Rue goes to the baseline, finds herself behind it. Nice find, extra pass. The three is gone and is way long. Rue gets the defensive rebound and Japan want to run. They go cross court, feet set for three.
Wow. This is the joy we've spoken about. It's such pleasure to watch this Japanese team. It's just a quick first pass, strong to weak side, shot open, wow.
I don't care who comes out of this game. Yeah. They have a real shot of progression if they play with this type of freedom, this type of pace.
It really is shame that they have met at this stage of the tournament.
What a move. What a move. Li Yuan, if they get to show you that again, watch the hesitation that freezes. There's a guy in the back row that took that little hesitation. She got to the basket unopposed and the whole defense was frozen. Almost a travel. That's an option to pass out. And Japan, for the first time, lose a little bit of rhythm offensively. It was the penetration that stopped and the ball got slowed up. That's what happens to them. They still have the four-point lead with three to go.
And this is that great hesitation you have just mentioned, Mark. It's such effective for guards, especially if the game is a high percentage of shooting like this, because players trying to contest every single sign of shooting. So, great read.
Xiao Ting needs a pass, goes to the wing. Great closeout. Malone just makes them put it on the floor. The two is good.
And Mavuri doesn't want to commit another personal foul because she's been playing so far on two personal fouls, and China needs to recognize it and try to attack her in defense.
Anyway, with the two, scoreboard on your graphic hasn't ticked over yet, but it is a two-point game. The three with Takada's hand, there's a hand in the face, can't get it to drop.
Defense, Takada playing fronting Liziero.
Tijing in the lane has the kick. Xiao Ting five on the possession. Li Yuan goes up, throws it inside. Yuru goes up with the left hand and makes the little baby hook.
And that's just that 1 second of resting defensively from Takada. She's having excellent tournament, but really, you can't rest not even for 1 second against Chinese team.
Tied at 41, 1:30 to go. And China needs to get this, and they get the steal. Need a pass, Xiao Ting, as always, down the floor. China lead it by two. Japan take the timeout, and for all their brilliance, for all their three-point shooting, China have now taken the lead over Japan. With that layup, China had the lead, 43 to 41, 1:26 to go in the half.
It's just an excellent effort and percentage from Chinese team to punish these turnovers of Japanese. Eight turnovers for Japan. Three out of them has been in this quarter. So they really need to look after the ball. Especially when you lose the ball on the top of the key, there's no one really to protect this break. And Xiao Ting really runs the floor today.
Well, those numbers, everything leveling out a little bit, 68-67%, I think, across the stats here. There's going to be pretty much parity. Takada, if I'm, you know, a little concerned, if that's not too strong a word, looks a little bit down on her energy level. She's been so phenomenal for this whole tournament so far, and she has a great motor, but leads the tournament in minutes played, and at some point it's going to catch up with you.
Yeah, but she's the player at this tournament playing so far the most minute, 115. She's averaging 38 minutes per game, which in this tempo, she might need a bit of a breathe out, and this time I could definitely help her to recover a little bit physically.
In the half court, you're back live. Achida needs a pass, gets a pass. Well, they settle for the three and just knock it down again in rhythm. Mizuyawa is just never going to pass up the look from the three-point line. Mizuyawa just loves that responsibility, shooting great numbers. Xiao Ting attacks it, gets to the far side of the ring, throws the lefty hook, doesn't get it. Yuru's on the glass, puts it on the floor, the extra pass, and trying to go back to the post. And there's probably a hand in the back. Bowers on the floor. Takada took one for the team. 40 seconds to go in the first half. Japan somehow only have a one-point lead after shooting phenomenally from the three-point line. And the somehow is down to how well China have played. This is a game of basketball, full stop. At the highest level, 44 to 43, 40 seconds remaining in the half. China out of bounds. Well, they move off the screen and just drop the three. Li Meng reestablishes China's two-point lead.
When Li Meng and Xiao Ting is on the court for China, they're such a dangerous team offensively because both guards are dangerous to the shot and to the penetration.
10 left on the possession, 14 on the half. There's around a 5-6-7 differential. Inside out, extra pass, wide open, is short. Lelouis gets the offensive rebound, gets an angle, can't get the drop. And will China get the shot away? No, they won't. And at the end of the first half. Let's just catch your breath for a second. Let's just confirm that China have a 46-44 advantage over Japan at the half. That has been a great half of basketball, 46-44. Statistically, well, look, we said it would even itself out. It pretty much has. Rebounds, everything, steals for China, but overall, you've got stats that support a 46-44 margin. 8 turnovers for Japan is their only real negative. But that has been a half of basketball. That's probably been the most competitive, most intense half we've had since we've been here, but this is knockout basketball now. So we're gonna leave you, get a drink, take a seat, relax, get back here in around 10 minutes, and we'll see you for the second half. See which of these two teams will progress to face Australia in the quarterfinal of the FIBA Women's World Cup. welcome back to Tenerife. As you see, Nakamura in shot. They're not bad numbers, should we say. 56% from the field, 67% from the three, and she's thrown a few assists as well. And Murahashi really did set the tone for the Japanese lineup. China, you've got to give them credit though. They literally have withstood a absolute barrage of Japanese pressure, have responded really well, and have managed to get back and lead it by two. Xiao Ting, as always, and as she's done throughout her career, and now she's got a team to do it with as well. It's just like the sock, the real rock that this team builds itself around, really composed. And she is that experienced player. 12 points, 6 from 7 from the field. But this really is, it's not talk about these two as just two teams from Asia that are going to play today and then lose to Australia tomorrow. Again, Japan beat Australia in the Asia Cup. If Australia are smart, I can't believe they won't be here. They'll be here somewhere, scouting this game as well as obviously taking the film and analyzing it, because if you do not stop either of these teams moving the ball, you are in a bit of a problem. That picture there, Teresa, tells you everything you need to know about this Chinese team. They're up two in a game that's on the verge of taking them to a quarterfinal of the World Cup, and there's smiles in the huddle. Start of the third quarter, start of the second half. Japan with the possession. Murahashi gets it to Kataru, who takes it on the drive and tries to find the easy two for Onega. Okeren can't complete the play. They will go to the free throw line. Takata with a nice pass. Go through that contact, finish the play.
In Japan so far shooting 80% from foul line.
Gets the drop. Great move. They're going to call it offensive.
Yep. Okay, let's see a replay of this move. If we're gonna get it. But again, it just shows that Li Meng and Xiao Ting are such effective guards for China. As soon as they spot the space, they go and aggressively penetrate.
Well, Murahashi has it. A little messy to start too this second half. That'll last long. Murahashi, pick and pop action. inside, outside, trying to make a nice adjustment to protect the penetration. Odahashi backs it out, looks a little space, needs a pass, finds one. Uzuyala gives it up to Takata for three. Ooh. It's good. Well, they explored the penetration two or three times, couldn't get it. Takata just spots up and knocks it down.
And this is the beauty of both teams' game. When it comes to the clock limit, they don't just focus on two players playing pick and roll. They all get involved, even if it's 2 seconds left.
Inside, nice duck by Xiao Ting. Steps through, beautiful move. Just gets composed. The defense just has to stop that free foot. They go the other way. Yuru comes down with a defensive rebound. The trap coming at the half. We've got a blocking foul. You've got to give so much credit to Li Yuan. Actually recognized the trap was coming and then just attacked the front side of the trap. You have to try and beat one of the trap. You can't beat both. Yuru gets the rebound. And she's had a very, very effective game as Li Yuru. Doesn't get some of the headlines of Han Zhu, but has been very effective today. Li Yuan with the pull-up is no good. And there she is again on the glass and puts it back for two. China with the two-point advantage. This is nip and tuck. Takata wide open again from the three-pointer. This time it's short. Can't chase her own rebound down. You can see her thinking here. Yuru is not getting her feet out quick enough. She's got the wide open look. She's got to take it.
And she made one right the possession before, so why not? You can't blame her for taking this shot from the three-point line. It's always very important how you step into the third quarter of the game, just to nice. Set the tone for second half.
This penetrates, in front of Chi Ying, pulls up, ooh, gets the two. Yu Yang Xijing. Fake, gets into the space, just puts it up quick. Louis is blocked, and China come down with it. China enjoying their biggest lead of the game here by four, 52-48. And it's their turn to get the momentum. Just a strong move, cute little finish.
And smart move as well from Li Meng. Knowing that Mamuli is on two personal fouls, she's not going to play as aggressive defense.
Japan will hit the second side. He puts it on the floor. Has to go out to Takata. Thought about the mid-range. Puts it on the floor. Goes up. Is blocked. And there'll be a 24 violation.
It almost felt that China forced Japan a little bit too static their game offensively, not as what they've been playing until now so far.
Well, Japan have literally been stopped in their tracks at the start of the third. It's China line up being very, very effective right now. Xi Jing going up, gets the two. Power it inside. Be quick, but power it inside. Huang Xijing. It on the floor. Yoka stops and pops, and it's the lids on the hoop. It's an 8-point game. All of a sudden, China have possession. Inside out. Yu Yuan for three is no good. And the ball will return to Japan. They dodged the bullet there because Li Yuan was wide open on the perimeter.
Well, it's been a great kick from Li Meng. Recognize it, and she had two defensive players, and that's the exact moment you gotta kick the ball out.
Maniga Akoki gets the first minutes of this playoff game.
Yeah, Coach Hawaza is trying to now change a little bit of rhythm because Akoki has been really effective, and she's quite a quick player, so Chinese really need to put her out.
Ashi will move it on. Koki puts it on the floor. Monohashi thinks, puts it down, steps back. Long two is okay. Good. Yeah. just give it to Xiao Ting, who attacks the middle. Whoa. Help comes. Great turnover. Defense. And Motohashi is the man, the girl again who makes it happen. Okoyigo is up, needs an angle, goes with a reverse layup and blows it. And China will turn it over. It's all a little frantic. Lakoki was didn't need to go over, you know, with the reverse layup. Could have literally just turned and kissed it off the glass for two of a much easier shot. But that's easy for me to say, sitting here. I don't have the Yuru trying to block my shot. But anyway, 5:27 to go in the third. Motohashi's just been so impressive. Is gone. She will never turn it down. Never ever will Miyazawa turn down the shot. Goes to 12 personal on 4 from 6. And it was out to 8. It's back to 3. And don't go to the post. They have a reluctance to throw it into the post when Yuru's there.
Great defense. Great defense from Motohashi.
They take the one off the glass. They don't get the drop. Who's coming up with it? Japan will control the basketball, and Motohashi chases it down quicker than anybody else. Looks to turn the corner. Now that she needs a pass, skips it. Okoki on the perimeter, fires the three, is short. It's up and down. Li Meng gets to the inside, steps through, blows the two-footer. And the foul will be called on Wang Siyu, I think, or is it?
No, Motohashi picked up the second personal foul.
Motohashi's going to sit down.
But again, we could see Li Meng being really aggressive into the rim. She's just excellent. She just draws the contact with her defender. She's not trying to avoid it. She's trying to get into the contact to know, oh.
I, as I said, the foul was called the other way.
Oh, okay.
Foul's on Wang Siyu.
I think even the graphic has been a bit confused. You're right, Mark.
I hope so, because we're going that way. Jioko gets it off. Miyazawa stops, needs a pass, finds a pass.
Great help from Rikai.
Jioko in the lane. To attack out of the ball, they turn it over. China make the substitution and will be joined by Wang Ziyumeng, who gets her first minutes decent. So both teams going a little deeper into the bench in this third. They go back door in the cut, and then we get back into the play to knock it out of bounds.
Yeah, it's now Seattle didn't really use the spacing good enough because the wing has been wide open for the shot, and her teammate Wang Ximeng even showed her the possible up. Oh, she needs the ball out there. Lake Seattle needs the ball.
I have a real reluctance to give it to her in the post. China missed the three. Japan in transition. Let's both teams a little rhythm's gone, a little bit disjointed. Great penetration over Yuru, which changes the shot. Again, great ring protection. Far side of the ring, off the glass. It's good for two, and you can see how intent that was. Tough, tough move to the far side of the ring. Got a whistle on the play. Malui gets, draws contact as she turned the corner, went down the middle.
And now we see on both sides that the players are attacking the middle of the paint, and that's just the quickness they have. They're using the moment of the close-up from defense to go against their feet into the middle of the paint to try to create or attack the basket. Great penetration from Zhang Liwei.
And Zhu checks in. Koi with her feet set and all day to knock down the three.
Oh,
that top. China a little static at the moment.
It's been great rotational move right now defensively.
Inside out. Yang Liwei just counts another one from deep.
And you could see that Monica Okoye just turned back towards her player and just went right up the big and forgot completely Yang Liwei. And that just tells you the tactic of Japanese defense.
Great first step, looks to attack the middle. Machida's going to have to come back out. Nice pass. Takada can't get it to drop. And China dodged the bullet because they did not pick up the weak side, strong side cut at all. But Yang Liwei gets China into the half court. Si Mengran extends it. They're going to try and gap Zhu Han from there. Nice look over the defense for two.
And one. Yang Xing plays an impressive game. 4 assists already, 9 points on her own, 6 rebounds.
Simon Graham on the free throw line.
Now we can see that China is using the size advantage they have within their roster against Japan.
Chance to equal their biggest lead of the game if this drops, which it does. Kao will check in for her first minutes of the game. Machida will advance the basketball. Get into this weave action again. Machida out top. We get the Takahata screen. That ball, that pass just leaves it to the ring. But when you've got 2.5 meters coming to help, Zhang Yu gets another block. Gets it on the second trial, but fumbles. Ball's recovered. Japan have bodies down the floor. Machida has it. Not as organized as they have been. Machida gets it. We'll get the ball screen and turns it down. Machida tries to turn the corner and kicks. Akoki breaks to the middle, goes with the right hand, and is fouled. Will peel herself off the floor and step to the free throw line.
And again, you could see Monica Okoye use the advantage because she made the long distance shot before. And she just made Sun Mengran to try to lift on her feet to block the potential shot, and she went under her arms into that penetration. Great move from Okoye.
Is he giving her back? He's giving her two.
Yep.
Something happened that we didn't like. So she's still shooting two. They can wipe the first one off. No one understands what's going on at the moment. She's 0 for whatever the case is. There's still one to come. The first one was retaken. The second one missed. And now we will get the live shot.
Hopefully now we're on the same page. Good.
And she knocks it down and desperately needed to do so. Chance for China to get a 9-point or 10-point lead, which would be their biggest lead of the game so far. Well, they're going to leave a wide open, just buries it. Absolutely bury. Yang Liwei is on fire from deep. Got a 10-point game, last minute of the third. Turnover, recovered by Takada, now turned over. Xiao Ting, great hands to recover. Open for three, the bench is up, the ball is short. But Xiao Ting comes up with an offensive rebound. Neither one of these teams ever stops working. Zhu Han goes baseline, doesn't get a touch. Thing off the glass is no good. And you've got to say, Japan just literally dodged the bullet. Machida gets it to Takada. Backs it out. McCoy is going to set the ball screen. Gives herself a little separation. Backs it, gets space off the one step, blows the layup. Until then, it was perfect. Now China should get the last shot of the third quarter. 7 on the clock.
Yang turns the corner, needs a pass, puts it over the top. Wuhan tries to manufacture an angle, but was behind the backboard. And that's been a tremendous quarter for China. Relentlessly built the 10-point lead. And at the end of three, they lead it 67-57. Japan have a lot to do. And China at the moment are in control. Numbers. Japan have dropped down to 58% from three. It's still an impressive number, but their two-point stats have now just, they've had issues scoring, and the size in particular of Li Yiru and Han Zhu has been a factor in changing shots. So as much as anything else, that's led to Japan really struggling inside the keyway. There's still a long, long way to go in this, 67-57. Australia is the prize, the quarterfinal of the Women's World Cup. What a tournament Asia Cup becomes now that both New Zealand and Australia are playing it, with Japan, with China, with Korea that were also here, with some of the other emerging countries from that region. One of the regional championships is going to be so interesting to watch as FIBA changed the women's calendar. Different series of qualifiers. More competitive games is good for all the teams in that region. So China, with the first look at the half court, they lead by 10. They have the basketball. Peng Liwei, nowhere to go, needs a pass, just about gets it away. He almost gets a piece of it. It's short, what a rebound, Xiao Ting. Came from nowhere, goes inside. Great rotation. Why wouldn't it be Morabahashi? Gets to the foul line, doesn't like her options, will back it out.
It would be really important how Japan right now is going to keep moving the ball offensively against the size of Chinese team.
Takada gets cut off. Five on the possession. Odahashi gets into the foul line. Takada, long two, is short. Offensive rebound. Belongs to Miyazawa. Wului, lane wide open for two.
That was a very smart move. Again, she has recognized there's no one on the split line, and she attacked San Su as she's way quicker player.
Then outside, we'll hand it off. Penetration off the glass, blocked. Tremendous strength by Nagaoka. China will get deeper into rotation. Huang Xijing checks in, as does Li Yuan. Li Yiru will check in. The 19-year-old replaces the 18-year-old.
Isn't it that great? Future potential for China.
Wow, it's all the 2 meter player replacing the 2 meter five player. The numbers just keep adding up for China.
Anywhere you put it, it's just a great whoa, and that's
just come off the bench, make a little back cut after the screen, get the two. This nicely executed play, 10-point lead. Morihashi going straight down the middle, will kick it again, attack the closeout. Morihashi is wide open, put him in the book. It's all about Morihashi. Can she do enough to lead this Japanese lineup back into the game. Buries the three. Yuru inside, gets a little contact, hangs on. Xiao Ting into the lane, takes the tough runner, doesn't get the drop. And a team rebound for Japan. And why wouldn't Murahashi get it? Gets to the foul line, drops it inside for the two, and they blow it, they'll take the foul. And Moeko Nagaoka is cursing herself here. Could have been looking at an M1. Could have been looking at cutting it to a 5-point game. She's got to go to the free throw line just to get the two.
But again, quick break from Murahashi, and she has dragged the defenders on herself, open up her teammate. But Moeko Nakanoka needs to make these shots.
Especially if you're going to miss the free throw, stay on the line. It's one of those must stay on the line moments. Keep your feet still, shoot the ball. 7:47 in what's been a classic so far. Still an eternity to go. 69-62. Chance to make it a 6-point game, which she does. Trap for Li Yuan, and is this the moment that Japan tries to really raise the tempo again? The open three is good. Hu Wang Xijing knocks down the three and orchestrates a reaction from the fans behind the Chinese bench. Murahashi in the lane for two, doesn't get the drop, the offensive rebound is brought back.
She hasn't been too confident to attack Li Xieru, so she has moved the ball, trying to get it back, and look at that penetration, even though she even had her teammate on a mismatch. So great decision from Murahashi.
Note to the stat man, that's an assist off the glass. Yang gets the runner in the lane for two.
Just, you almost look for where is the weak points of these teams, but they're just playing an excellent game on both ends.
Takada wants to move the ball, does. That'll be a foul. China's second team foul. Xiaoting picks up her first. That's the other thing for anyone watching this. These teams play as aggressive or as quick as you can defensively, yet they do it within the rules. They do not foul that excessively at all. That's only the second foul of the quarter, and both teams are getting after it. Physicality does not necessarily mean the foul.
Exactly, and then just running up and down, it tells you how conditioning is important at this level of basketball as well.
Also, Hachi will look at the ball screen option she has. Breaks down the middle, kicks it. Malui with three is off. What a rebound! But then recovered with Xijing with the block. They go long. Yuru holds, needs a pass, has got a pass. They swing it. And somehow we've all calmed down in the half court.
Beautiful.
Great high-low, great seal, great two.
And this is what you want to see, such a beauty when two big players see each other and know about each other. Just a change angle play, high-low, and wide open look down for Li Xieru.
Well, Japan have taken the timeout. They're down 11. It's the latest biggest lead for China. They're hanging around between 8 and 10, 8 and 11. Japan are going to have to get it under six. Just feel like they're making progress. It stops at the moment. They're just unable to get enough stops to get any momentum and run back into the game. Their offense is functioning, although obviously, as you can see, the percentages are dropping. And that is really about ring protection as much as anything else. But they cannot get stops. Great numbers off the bench. China. It's not just Han Zhu that comes in. Huang Xijing didn't start. She's had a nice game. So the future is bright for Chinese basketball. But in the moment, they are 6 minutes away from a quarterfinal against Australia that I genuinely believe they think they would win or could win. And that will be the same for Japan as well.
And you're right, because China really played excellent game against USA at this tournament as well. scoring 88 points against this so-quality team of US. So they definitely have a true potential, and I'm pretty sure Australia is carefully watching today this game, scouting and trying to find the weak point of Chinese team or Japanese. Who knows who's going to grab this win today?
Six minutes to go in the fourth. Urahashi outside, will move it on, gets it back. Louis tries to turn the corner. That'll be the third team foul for China. And said that no one fouls. They fouled twice in a minute. It's all about the catch. It's all about the timing and the read. Crucial moments for Japan. This, there is an eternity to go, but it cannot let the lead grow. You'd like to think if you're a Japanese fan, you're going to cut this to a single-digit lead before there is five, you know, under five to go. Motohashi, great first take and step by Nagioka in the lane off the glass, doesn't get the drop. There's a battle going on in the glass, and Japan rewarded for the effort with the end line ball. It's a new full team.
It's a shame now Miyazawa hasn't recognized that mismatch Takada had, because she had Li Yuan on her back, which has 170 centimeters against Takada's 183.
Well, Mitsuhashi takes the three that is off and not in rhythm.
Yeah, and that's what we have to give the China credit, Chinese defense, because they're really now trying, Japanese, to take these early shots or unprepared, because their game is to score off the movement, ball movement, bodies movement. But in this second half, we're seeing that China forced Japan many times to this kind of unbalanced shot for them offensively.
Okoye checks in. Nagawaka sits. Meng has it. Choosing out top, looks underneath, doesn't make the pass. So China go a little smaller, a little more active.
Yeah.
And Takada's going to pick up the personal.
It's been only 2 seconds on the shot clock. You don't want to commit foul at this situation. It's just giving another 14 seconds to Chinese offense.
Xiaoting at the moment not in the game. I don't think that's going to last for too long if China feel they have to close this out. Xijing puts it on the floor. Three on the possession. They take a tough runner. Hits nothing. That'll be a 24 violation. China will take their first time out in the second half. 76-65, they lead it. 5 minutes away. 5 minutes away from the quarterfinal of the Women's World Cup. Japan have got to make a change here. They've got to try and generate a stop to start eating into this lead. It's a fascinating situation. China are going to want to open this out to 15. Japan just want to cut it, keep it under 10. Give yourself a chance down the stretch.
I agree with that, Mark, and it'll be interesting to see if Japan is going to come out with the full court pressing and change a little bit dynamic of the game, because right now China works them really pretty well and using their size against Japanese.
Yang Li Wei, 16 points, 4 from 6 from 3. She's been absolutely phenomenal in the second half, really has. And her combination with Li Yuan in the backcourt, whether they're on the floor together or just rotating between them, it's just been a phenomenal performance by the pair of them. Li Meng sits. And Japan into the half court.
Murahashi takes it strong, gets the two. That's a tough, tough move.
Yeah, that's been again a recognition. There's no one on the split line from Chinese defense.
A little flash to the middle. Turnaround is short. Well, Menglan and Murahashi takes the ball screen from Takada. Murahashi gets to the lane, needs a pass. Louis takes the bounce pass in the lane for two, nice. Gets the roll.
That's a quick 4 points right now. It's so important for Japan, these quick 4 points to stay and decrease the margin for the last 4 minutes of this quarter.
Xiaoting goes left off the glass, and she just is, well, unstoppable is too strong a word, but she can just go through contact. Made that move in every single game. She's 8 from 10, and it's not as if she's surprising anybody. Takada does the same the other way, but blows the layup, can't get it away. Malui will save that. Takes the three, is off, and that is a rebound by Sun Menglan.
Now we can see a trap coming.
Turnover. 2-on-1 break. And Hashi drops it in to Koki, and she gets the 2-7-point game.
And this is a tactical change we wanted to see. Quick trap from Japan, use the momentum for the surprise, and run a quick break.
Kids having a great time. Almost fumbled. They go back door, they miss it. Yuan.
Ooh, that's
oh, she. The backcourt combination. Yang Linwei and Li Yuan are just filling it up for China. Takada moves it on. Louis with the three, doesn't get it, but the offensive rebound. Koki gets another two. At the moment, though, it's 3 for 2. 8-point game. Li Yuan. Turnover. Koi is everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. That's 6 points in a row for her. Timeout China. They have to burn a second timeout. Little run there makes it a 6-point game. It's been on turnovers and fast break options. And Japan get themselves right back in it.
And again, that has been a great tactical instructions from Coach Havasa, because you can see clearly that they tried something different, but didn't work so far. They went and trapped the Chinese team and tried to put them under pressure to commit these turnovers. This is a points from turnover for Japan, 20 to 10 of Chinese. And it just tells you how effective they are defensively and then transition offense into the break. And as you said, both teams, they just don't rest. They just go, then giving everything they have in this game, obviously, because one of the teams gonna finish at this tournament. So really exciting 2 minutes ahead right now to see who's gonna grab that win.
Well, Li Yuan is going to sit with Yang Lai Wei, who's trying to lead this Chinese team and get them over the line. They still go, but they bring back Li Yuru. So they're back with a much more predictable lineup. They went that period without Li Ru or Zhang Zhu for the first time in the tournament. Full court pressure by Japan, just about beat the five count. Trap comes straight away. And Louis is after it.
It's going to be a lot on the point guards of both teams right now. How are they going to control the tempo of the game?
Puts it on the floor, gets inside and kicks. Ooh. Turnover. Koki's got, and this has to be unsportsmanlike from the side. Wasn't really a genuine attempt to play the basketball. And it's going to be 2+ possession. Key moment for Monica Koki. Will she make the two? If she does, she really does give Japan a real opportunity. That's an unsportsmanlike foul, has to be called.
Referee gets it exactly right.
Li Meng's going to sit. Li Yuan comes back. They go to two guards.
Makes the first.
She goes two for two. Silence in the gym as she knocked those down. She's had a big 12 points off the bench in this second half. Didn't play in the first half. She's been enormous in this fourth quarter.
Like a joker,
eight,
the Japanese
quarter
team.
Points, yeah, absolutely. Sideline possession. Mizuyawa gets it in. Morohashi, where she wants to be in a big game with the responsibility. Morohashi attacks the drive lane, goes up for two. Oh, what a move! How quick was that? She just sliced to the hoop. 2-point game, 1:40 to go. Morohashi, 23 huge ones. Almost a turnover. Japan just smelling it right now. Japan and Morohashi will get the call for the reach. Only their second team foul. Morohashi picks up her second. 81-79. Jiaxing will relieve the pressure. Yuru out top, needs a pass, finds one. Xiaoting tries to turn the corner again. In the lane for two. Doesn't get the drop, but gets a rebound. Yuru's deep, she's very deep, off the glass for two. Rewarded for the effort on the glass. Takada puts it on the floor, feels some contact, is blocked. Sai Singh says, get out of here, this is where I live.
Indeed, indeed. It's been great help from the weak side from Guotsuan Singh to cover this Takada's penetration. And we haven't seen it much because no one stops Morohashi, but when Takada penetrated, they just smashed her. So great defensive possession right now for China.
Big end line. Whoever she's praying to, it doesn't matter. She's getting every piece of help that she can get for her team. And China go as small as they've been in the whole tournament. They go over three guards set on the out of bounds. 12 seconds on the reset. Takada's wide open. They take the two and they could have had Takada underneath. Wow, what a breakdown. Decisions under pressure. China spread it. 40, just over 40 to go. Japan trust their defense. A little whistle now. Travel cord. Japan have options. Timeout for Coach Obasi. He needs something quick. And he's alive and kicking still in this playoff game.
Yeah, and this is that, Trevor. Before you bounce the ball, you gotta put the... Before you lift the feet, you need to bounce the ball. It's just an incredible game of the point guard positions as well, I'd say, because both point guards really controlling the game. Morohashi on her own scoring 23 points, but on the other hand, Li Xuan, 7 assists, delivering, playing for her teammates, supported by Huan Singh. It's just, look at these numbers, free throws, really high for China. Japan a little bit dropped down percentage-wise. Just, wow, still 40 seconds to go, that's a long time for both teams.
Only 5 free throws on the game. China tells you a lot about the discipline of the Japanese defense. Obasi. He's got to get a quick one. Got to draw it up to get a quick one. Japan still go quick. They go without either of the bigs.
quite as small as they were on the previous possession, but small enough. Japan on the sideline, Motohashi will bring it in. Louis is open and returns the corner. Well, why not? It's short though, Takada tried to clear out instead of just trying to score. Japan chasing, cannot foul. They do foul now to try and give themselves a chance to control it. Still time in the game, 24.5 seconds, 17 on the possession. Takada picks up foul number three. China decide not to take the time. They only have one left. Player decision on the floor for China. Oh. Can't get it in, just get it in. Why wouldn't they go to Xiao Ting? Extra pass, wide open. They're not going to put it up. Going to move the basketball. China passing their way to the quarterfinal of the Women's World Cup. 13.4. And Motohashi was the only one who got anywhere near anyone to foul them. Sideline possession. Both teams now in the penalty.
Great control of Chinese offense right now to avoid that foul from Japan.
Yang Wei will inbound. Same play. They come out of the stack. Xi Jing goes to the basketball. Ooh. Just about get it in, and there's a foul on the pass. Must have been very, very close to a 5 second call. Iwasawa picks up the first foul. Very close to a 5 second call. The equation for Japan is simple. It's going to be a two possession game regardless. If they make both, it's a two possession game still. It's a 5 point game. If they make this, it's a 6 point game, 2 threes to tie it. 12.8, more than enough time. Crucial shot in terms of the options that China have. Makes both. Obasi takes the timeout. He has 12.8 seconds to conjure up some magic, because that's what he really needs now. He needs an out of bounds with a quick shot. China will pretty much guarantee take the timeout to advance the ball. But the other option for China is to foul, which will obviously make it a three possession game. Four and 43 on the field goal front. Japan, after that red hot start, cooled down to just good numbers.
Slant, mean a slant, what got it? So that I slant and say screen, pop, pop, pop. Okay, shoot.
Just we would say one team has lower percentage from 3 point, but having this percentage, 56 and 48, is just an incredible number from that distance. Japan won't like is that percentage from free throw, only 69, missing four open free throws, and that could cost them the game. Not only that, obviously, that would be more factors, because China really has a wide bench contribution in today's game, which really shows the power of Chinese future.
Here we go then, 12.8 seconds. Japan needing some magic on the sideline. Motohashi will inbound. Surely they have to go and get it up quick, which they are. They're going to go up with a three, is off, and China get the rebound, and they make the pass, but they couldn't get it away before the foul. 5.7. It's never over until it's over, but these free throws will ice the game. Yuheng Xijing, her contribution in the second half and in the fourth quarter at both ends of the floor has been crucial. Just strokes the first of the throws.
Yeah, 7 assists, 9 rebounds, 13 points, shooting 71 from the field. Great, great performance.
She makes both. Motohashi has it. She's going to have to put one up and put it up quickly. Goes strong to the lane for two. She'll count that. But it won't be enough. Because the team from Asia that's going to the quarterfinals is China. That is a hell of a game. It won't mean anything to Japan at the moment, but they played absolutely phenomenally. They were coached tremendously. But China didn't panic under the first quarter and first half onslaught. And they come back to win it, 87-81. Just a tremendous game of Women's World Cup basketball here in Tenerife. And the Chinese caravan rolls on to the quarterfinal. It rolls on to a tie against Australia. And if Australia are watching, we're all looking forward to that one because they have a game that can trouble anyone in the world. Tremendous performance by China. Their belief in each other is unquestioned. Great job by coach Du Li Min. He didn't panic. His staff came up with the answers. And they move on. Coach Ovasi takes the loss as you would expect him to take it, with a great deal of dignity. Has moved this Japan program on. Current Asia Cup champions will leave the World Cup at the first knockout game stage. They do what they always do. Win or lose, they thank their fans. When they reflect, they'll think of positives. At the moment, their emotions tell you everything they put into that game. What a performance, what a team. Here are the numbers. China with 56% from three, 53% from the two. Won the rebound battle, slightly won the assists, and in the end, just about won the game. That was an absolute privilege of a game to cover. Teresa, stats tell you all sorts of things. 87, 86 are the only ones that matter, but just a game of basketball.
Yeah, I wouldn't really worry too much about assists because the performance from both teams has been just incredible in this game. The level of intensity and of determination to grab the win in this game, it has been just a pleasure to watch. And I really feel sorry that these two nations has met in this qualification of quarterfinals. But hey, this is a World Cup. This is anything could happen. Here we see some top scorers from Japan. Motohashi, she was just incredible today, 25.7 assists on her own. But on the other hand, I think China really won this game with the wider bench and wider rotation, with more player being a kind of important element in this game. We've seen Kaun Singh's second half incredible, 14 points, 9 rebounds, 7 assists, just wow. But what most, I think the point guards has been in this game just the key elements as well. Because they are the brain on the court, they are the right hand of the coaches, and both coaches has just shown a great strategy, preparation and game plan. Li Mingxiu on the side of China and Coach Ovase on the side of Japan. It's, you know, as you said, Japan's going to definitely reflect on this game, and they must be happy from the performance they've been showing at this tournament. I know right now it's a very disappointing moment for them to not make the quarterfinals. But hey, you know, like, you've made the World Cup, which is the top place to play, and there will be no easy games in this tournament, and China just proved that, because the level of the conditioning they had as well, the way the coach has coached his players and used them in the game, is just an incredible watch, and I'm super happy to witness in person this game of a high-level basketball.
Lots of examples in these highlights of where China, as well as they shot the ball from the three-point line, well, Japan shot the ball well too, but on the inside at the forward spot and the young Twin Towers, because they had a really, again, combined, very, very efficient game. They shot the three well, you expect that, but on the inside they were very, very effective. Xiao Ting just, again, showed what a great leader she is in terms of leading by example. Yuru had her best game of the competition so far. Just played efficiently. And it, when Japan do sit down, one of the heroes of this competition for them, Maki Takada, just needs a little bit more support in that power forward role. She's carried this team in that role for every game. Her minutes have been enormous in terms of just totals. Did it catch up on her today? Well, she was going up against a whole series of Chinese matchups. But Japan, in their journey that they're on, as they go towards an Olympic Games, are in a very, very good place. A good place that's going to excite the fans in Japan. And you know what? It excites the basketball world as well, because that's a game that's going to put a smile on the face of everybody. There's the quarterfinal sum up of today. There's the first result. We've got Nigeria and Greece to come, with France, Turkey, Spain, Senegal later. But China are the first team through to face Australia in the quarterfinals. But for now, I hope you've enjoyed that one. I know I have. From Tenerife, it's goodbye.